we've been recording together all this week. So earlier on, I managed to catch up with my colleagues to chat a bit about our influences and inspirations. Some brilliant female composers that we've been discovering, yet more brilliant female composers we've been discovering. We talked a little bit about what it's like to work together in such a close-knit group of us on the top line.
Do you have any sort of influences or inspiration growing up from kind of, hello, all of you girls, any female influences you had growing up who kind of maybe move you towards music? And doesn't have to be any, can be famous or not, or
well, it's my mum for me, actually.
Yeah,
she grew up singing and with my dad's family, so they were best friends, and so we did it at home. And she was just, we always just loved it. It sounds really naff, but we used to sing madrigals.
It's
so cool.
It's the honesty chat. So,
yeah. Get it all out.
So yeah, I mean, sort of, yeah, just her really.
But I had a brilliant singing teacher at school called Mavis Hoban, who was married to John Hoban, who used to run the choir at the Oratory back in the day. And she had a car accident and lost her voice and just ploughed all of her energy into her pupils. She was just incredible and set me on the journey to go to Eton Choral Courses, which is where I met Julie.
Yeah.
And so really without her, it would have been very, very different, I think.
Yeah, I had a lovely singing teacher who just very local to where I grew up, Jill Bennett, she was then, she's now Jill Atkinson, and she was just amazing, and she conducted all the choirs locally as well, so she was just such a positive influence, and I definitely wouldn't be doing this without her, definitely.
Amazing.